It is an atmosphere like none other here today at Bobcat Stadium. These rivalry games, they're just a little extra on everything that goes on in a game like this.
You saw in the graphic, Montana coming into this one with some drill momentum. They did not have that last season. They ran out of gas late, did not qualify for the playoffs. That is an expectation each and every year for that program. So if they were to miss the FCS playoffs for two straight years, there'd be a lot of unhappy folks in Missoula, Montana. So you get ready. Jerry Louis McGee back deep to receive the kickoff for Montana. Gabe Peppinger to kick off for the Bobcats. Montana State won the coin toss, deferred. Jerry Louis McGee will take a knee. And Gresh Jensen will get his first opportunity to guide his offense today, starting first and 10 at the 25-yard line. Reese Phillips began the season as the starting quarterback for Montana, went down against Savannah State with a serious leg injury ending his season. Jensen has done a terrific job taking over.
Well, it was a battle in the spring between those two guys, and Reese Phillips, obviously the veteran, a little more experience, did a nice job. But Gresh has grown week in and week out, and Reese Phillips, quite frankly, has been great for him in the quarterback room, helping bring him along with the middle side of the game.
Season for Jeremy Calhoun, a 6 foot, 213-pound junior out of Long Beach Poly High School. 621 yards rushing, 4.3 yards per carry, 6 touchdowns, and got another terrific back in Elijah Lee as well. Here's Louis McGee. They like to get him out for those quick bubble screens, but well defended that time by the Bobcats.
Well, that's exactly what Bob Stitt likes to do, those almost an extended handoff. Just get the ball in the hands of your athletes and let them make plays. Really good open field tackling here by Montana State in the zone defense. You see McCabe and Big Nell and all the names you know. Bryce Alley playing his final game here at Bobcat Stadium, forcing their first third down of the ballgame.
Third down and 4. Jensen with some time as Justin Calhoun. So early opportunities with the football for the Calhoun twins. Tyrell Thomas with the coverage.
Well, that's a good matchup to watch. Tyrell Thomas, a young player back in the game. Jalen Cole is out for the first half of this game, a starting corner after a targeting call last week in the second half.
12-yard gain on that previous play. Here's Jeremy Calhoun out near midfield. We take a look at some of the key players to watch in this brawl of the wide.
Well, for Montana, Elijah Lee is going to have a big statement in this game. A good hard runner. Keenan Kern always comes up big in big games. And Bryce McCabe, he's that alley player that's got to play both against the run and the pass. He's going to have a big game for the Cats.
Second and 2, Calhoun. And he will have the first down. Great Kunkel, linebacker for Montana State, with a stop. Third leading tackler on this team. He came out of the secondary due to injuries. They moved him into the linebacker spot. He's done a very nice job at the will linebacker position. Jensen, tons of time. Has Keenan Curran. First down inside the Montana State 25-yard line.
Well, two things. First of all, great protection. Look how clean the pocket is for Gresh Jensen. That's a route that takes a long time. Then he does a nice job of flattening that throw out and give only Keenan Kern the shot.
24-yard gain, a handoff to Calhoun inside the 20 as Montana State is into the EQC red zone and getting there with a very up-tempo offensive flow right now.
Well, and really good balance, too, both the run and the pass as we see Elijah Lee check into the ballgame.
Second down and 5. Jensen on the keeper. Has some room and lunges for the first down. He is at the 10-yard line.
Well, that play call was perfect against the defense that Montana State had called. You can see Mac Bignell blitzing from that outside linebacker spot. And Gresh Jensen goes right to that spot he vacated, picking up another first down for the Grizz.
First First and goal at the 10 after the 8-yard gain by Jensen. He, the ball carrier. He was really impressive last week against Northern Colorado. Jason is as energetic, I think, as we've seen him this season as he went for 98 yards.
I think just in general, that run game for Montana has really started to find itself here in the last half of the season. A really good balance between Jeremy Calhoun, Elijah Lee, and then mix in the little run-pass option with Bress Jensen on the zone read.
And what we're seeing right now is what we saw last week. They had touchdown drives with their first three possessions last Saturday. Lee again drives down near the 3-yard line. Transfer from Washington State University, averaging 4 yards per carry. Hopskin telling us his confidence has been building with each and every week. Third and goal at the 3. Lee again will not get to the goal line, stacked up nicely by that interior Montana State defense.
Boy, Tucker Yates blew that thing up from the start. Watch Tucker Yates in the middle of the screen as the defensive tackle just immediately pushes the line back, creates a big pile, and that allows the linebackers, the safeties, everybody to come up and stop Montana short of the first down as the field goal unit now comes out. I think as good of a drive as that was for the Grizz, that is a huge win for the Bobcats to get off the field there.
Brandon Purdy on for a 20-yard field goal attempt, 12 of 14 on the season. Had a career long of 47 last week. And he puts the Grizz on the board. The opening drive results in a 3 with 10:13 remaining in this opening quarter of the 117th Brawl of the Wild. Montana with the 3-0 lead over Montana State. Jason, communication issues apparently with headsets, as you see on your left, Jeff Choate, head coach of Montana State, without headsets. Ty Gregorak, his defensive coordinator, was upstairs, apparently due to communication issues. He came back down onto the field, so they have to adjust to this early on.
Yeah, not happy when the stuff that's supposed to work, and that's the last thing you want to think about, doesn't. It kind of throws a little wrinkle in things. Bob Stitt, their headsets are now working. I know that's a communication between coaches is such a huge thing, especially when you're upstairs in the booth. You have a chance to see down on the field from a wider angle and get an idea how teams are lining up against you early. And if that communication is affected, that can certainly make things difficult on the field, and adjustments are delayed.
Tim Sabenza with the kickoff. Tyrell Burgess watches the ball roll by. Well, this is certainly one of the more dynamic running quarterbacks in all of college football. Chris Murray, second leading rusher in the Big Sky Conference, had his most balanced, consistent game, if you will, last week at Northern Arizona. And in this game last season, completed just 2 passes, but it was enough because he rushed for 142 yards and 2 touchdowns. We'll see how it plays out today for Chris Murray and this Bobcats offense. First down and 10 at the 25. Completion to Jabari Johnson. See how they use his size today, Jason.
Yeah, and they may not throw it a lot, but it's important to be effective when you do throw the ball. That first play, they had a spread set, and just by completing that pass and spreading the defense out, it makes sure that Montana respects them throwing the football, and that run game is certainly going to be a big part of the offensive game plan.
1 yard gain on first down. Murray to throw again. And a little miscommunication. Looked like Johnson broke that route off. And Murray went deep as we take a look at more of the key players to watch in today's game.
Well, career high last week, Nick Lassane is going to be a big factor today to take some of the heat off of Chris Murray running the ball. Kevin Cass is, keep an eye on him, not just receiving, a little razzle-dazzle in rivalry games, and he has two career touchdown passes. And then Josh Buss is a guy a lot like Mac Bignell that has to play both the pass and the run, a very, very aggressive player on that defense.
Murray using that mobility to buy some time as a catch out near a first down, and that went to Mitchell Herbert, one of 14 seniors on this Montana State team.
Well, you see a cut block. He's supposed to get rid of that. It's supposed to be a one step and fly, but the coverage was there. So now Chris Murray's running for his life, and not how you draw it up, but a great catch by Herbert keeping that foot down on the turf.
Mitchell Herbert has had a terrific career here. If he can get a touchdown catch today, that'll be his 21st, and that'll tie a school record with Kelly Davis. So back in 1986, first down carry, and the chains will move. Logan Jones. Just under 100 yards rushing on the season for Jones. It's kind of interesting. They came out and wanted to go into the air quickly, maybe thinking, yeah, Montana probably figures we'd just run the football. Nick Lassane into Montana territory. And had a terrific game last week. 19 carries, 184 yards, and a touchdown with a 74-yard run. Our first and 10 line is brought to you by the Northern Quest Resort and Casino. Second down and 6. Murray keeps it. Good pursuit. And down he goes. Josh Buss with the tackle. This is such a talented linebacking core for Montana. You have the second, fourth, and sixth leading tacklers in the conference in that group.
Well, they're always known for having athletic backers that can run sideline to sideline. This year, no different. Josh Buss might be as fast as they've ever had. Take a look at Favoroso and Banks. These guys all so effective in what they do. That front seven for Montana is as fast and agile as anybody in the country.
Called 42 Buss, apparently 43 Favoroso. And he's having an outstanding season as well. Murray. Ball drop, good coverage on that play. Darian Nash. Intended for Lance McCutcheon.
Well, they'll go back and look. From an accuracy standpoint, it was a good throw. You see Denarius McGee welcoming him there. Jeff Choate's talking to him. It's that half a second, not even a half a second, just a click sooner you throw that ball. The receiver's waiting for it. Darian Nash has a chance to react to it and knock it down. Again, not a bad throw, but not a great throw to convert on third down.
Jared Patmos is having a terrific season. And over him, Jerry Lee McGee Fields. It goes inside his 5-yard line, breaks a tackle, and still on his feet. And finally, down at the 16-yard line. Well, he's exciting. There's no doubt about that. This guy's exciting, too. Gresh Jensen on the first drive for Montana. Led his team to 3 points. They'll be looking for 7 when we come back.
Big Sky rivals Portland State and Eastern Washington have the Dan Cup in their sights.
Good find inside. Touchdown, Portland State.
It's Big Sky football on Root Sports. Today at 3, 4 Mountain.
Big Sky Football on Root Sports is brought to you by Pacific Northwest Carpenters Union, builders of industry, community, influence, and change. By CenturyLink, connecting you to the power of the digital world. And by Montana Toyota dealers. Let's go places. You know, one of the places you can go, the campus of Montana State University here in Bozeman, where Montana Grizzlies have the early 3-0 lead. Second offensive possession for Montana coming up. You get a good look at Bob Stitt, his third season leading the Grizzlies, an overall record of 21-13.
Well, that's impressive. best of two. Montana getting out to a fast start, undefeated this season when they score first. And Tom, I think it's important too that Montana State in this game is able to keep pace with Montana. They are not a team that is going to do well playing from too far behind, and not to say that they will in this game, but if they do, their offense is not built to do it.
Elijah Lee out to about the 20, check at the 19-yard line.
The first time they had the ball, Montana moved right down the field. Really effective drive, balance of run and pass, but then it just stalled down inside the 10-yard line. A great response by Montana State. We'll have to see if the Bobcats carry that momentum into this second drive and give their offense a better field position.
Second and seven. Interesting play call as you saw the motion by Samori Toure, who gets the carry. I don't think we've seen that from him, at least in the games we've called this year.
Well, that motion brought the linebacker back inside, giving their blockers an advantage to get to that leverage point.
On third and one. Lee did not get it. Denied. So once again, the interior, especially for this Montana State defense, rising to the occasion.
Yeah, and those big fellas for Montana are going to get challenged. Ty Gregorak is excited about the response. They can move up and down the field. They can have good plays on first and second down, but third down is where you win ball games on defense and getting off the field. His group has done it twice now. First, forcing a field goal, and this time getting off the field on Montana's second offensive possession.
Eric Williams on to punt, averaging 40.4 yards per kick this season. This is Kevin Cassis signaling for the fair catch at his own 35-yard line.
Well, communication issues are still an issue. You see Bob Stitt with his headset off. If one of the team has communication issues, the other ones have to take their headsets off as well. So you see the Montana coaches vacating from the coaches' booth upstairs. Jason Seymour, defensive coordinator. Now everybody's going to have to come downstairs until the communication issues get worked out. So a little gamesmanship taking place early on in this game.
So they're coaching just like they did back in that first brawl, way back when, right? Oh, now Cho just got a headset. Maybe they're starting to get those issues worked out. Lassane, 2-yard pickup. The sun breaks through the high clouds here in Bozeman once again this afternoon.
Man, look, he's got a headset. Why can't I have mine? So the refs are going to look into it. You know, from a head coach, where a lot of that is the decision-making on third down. Where's the spot? How many yards to go? Do we get the first down? Do we go for a replay? I mean, all these kind of things are really important decision-making items when you have coaches upstairs.
And Murray with a completion out near midfield. Connor Sullivan with just his sixth catch this season. Starting tight end, the junior out of Ennis, Montana.
Well, not a whole lot of decision-making there for Chris Murray. You're going to play that far off of Connor Sullivan. It's got to be a misalignment for Montana. You just don't leave any receiver that wide open. The quarterback's going to have 100% completion ratio and march right down the field.
12-yard gain. Passes in motion. And handoff to the true freshman, the two-way player, Troy Anderson. Dylan Montana, Jeff Choate said he asked Troy how he felt about getting ready for his first brawl of the wild, and Anderson told him, I want the ball.
That's exactly what you want to hear. That man's going to make a lot of plays for the Bobcats over the next several years. You see Jeff Choate now still has that headset on. Key second down play. And if they have this type of down and distance, second short, it's going to be a difficult day for that Montana defense to defend.
Well, Chris Murray, with three completions, already has more than he had in last year's brawl. Nowhere to go that time for Logan Jones, tackled for a loss. James Banks leading the way. Those talented linebackers for the Grizz.
Yeah, James Banks leading the way in tackles in the big sky. We talked about that second short. James Banks says, you know, I'm going to go ahead and put him back in third and long. I'll press you on those three completions, Chris Murray. I want to see you do more.
his headset back. We'll see if maybe coaches eventually will be heading back upstairs.
He'll be exhausted by the time the first half's over.
Third down and six. Murray gives some heat. Down he goes. James Banks with his fourth sack this season.
Well, we talked about Montana liking to bring pressure, and really, you have to pick the right time to do it. Great job getting past the blocks. You see Banks, you see Josh Buss. Big play on third down, and Chris Murray does a nice job of holding on to the ball, not forcing anything, but his team's forced to kick the ball away and kick it to a very dangerous returner in Jerry Louis McGee.
And just the rugby style end over end. Boop gets a very nice bounce. Louis McGee fields it. A good punt coverage by the Bobcats as Jerry Louis McGee is out at the 10-yard line. Still 3-0 Grizz in Bozeman.
To today's top athletes, In Depth brings you the full story.
Hi, everybody. Angie Mantic here at the Ford Sports Desk. Right now, it is time for Where I Root, presented by Payne West Insurance. And this is always an interesting day. Jake Zimmon, our play-by-play guy for the Portland Timbers, sends this one in the one day a year that divides our house. Good luck, Jake. And I don't necessarily mean with the game. I just meant with today. And Nate sends this one in. Go, Cats, go. Remember to use that hashtag, Where I Root, presented by Payne West Insurance. We'll try to get your photo on the air, especially when you're as adorable as this little one. Mini Monty says, go Grizzlies. I want to know, actually, if they can say that. That would be impressive. All right, Tom, back to you.
All right, Ange, thanks so much. You're going to get a ton of those coming in today, no doubt about it. Both coaches now with headsets, and hopefully all the communication they feel like they need. Jensen overthrows Jerry Louis McGee. I think he saw Matt Bignell come in his direction and maybe rush that throw just a little bit.
Yeah, threw high on the bubble screen, and it's a long throw, but certainly one that's just like playing catch in the backyard. And, you know, I think you get Matt Bignell bearing down on you, and a lot of guys are going to overthrow that ball. Get a little excited to see that man. There's a lot of big hits in his career. This is his final game at Bobcat Stadium.
He's played four different positions this season due to injuries, and there's our first flag today. I was just about to bring up the fact we had no penalties.
False start. Offense, number 51. 5-yard penalty, second down.
That is our appropriately named referee today, Scott Root.
There they are, coming back in the booth.
No, are we sure they didn't leave? The cinnamon rolls up here are delicious. I don't know if maybe they were just making one last rush. Second down and 15. And again, more movement on that Montana offensive line. So David Reese, maybe? We'll see.
False start. Offense, number 76. Penalties half the distance. Second down.
Well, it's not by accident. That's the Sonny Holland zone there, the student section, and Montana is backed up right to it on their own 2-yard line. They are getting an earful. What a great shot there. The closed end of the stadium, and it is loud down there. Two straight false starts, and wouldn't be surprised now if they start going on a silent count just to not put themselves in any more peril than they already have.
Second and 18 at the 2. Calhoun gets out near the 5-yard line, so a little breathing room as they'll now face third and long.
Interesting to see what Bob Stitt does here. He want to protect his freshman and not make him make a decision down the field, kick the ball away, and let his defense do the work, or are they going to try and push something down the field?
Third and 14. Jensen has a wide-open receiver dropping the football. Keenan Curran. He would have been near first down territory, so the punt team will come on.
You know, Keenan Curran is a guy that likes to catch the ball with his hands. Watch him here. The ball gets into him. And you'll always hear the coaches, get that ball out in front. You let it bounce off the shoulder pads, and bad things can happen. Almost an interception opportunity as a drop pass forces a punting situation.
Both teams now 1 of 3 on third down. Both teams struggled mightily on third down in this game last season. Williams on for the punt. signals for the fair catch. And excellent field position. We do have another flag on the field.
The head linesman preliminarily looks like a false start.
Illegal motion. Kicking team number 5. 5-yard penalty be added to the end of the kick. First down.
It's Kobe Eaton, backup wide receiver. Grizz fans, in case you missed it, Dahlberg Arena is getting a little facelift with a new center-hung video board. Get ready for a new game day experience for you and the family. Get your tickets to Grizz and Lady Grizz basketball games now by visiting grizztix.com or calling 1-888-MONTANA. The men's team in Montana got a win this week over Pittsburgh. So good early sign for that group. 38-yard line, first and 10, Murray and company. Handoff going to Edward Vander. That's his first carry in a month. Missed a couple of games due to a leg injury. Did play last week, but did not get a carry.
He's a good change of pace guy for him, too. Catches the ball out of the backfield and get to the sideline.
Sideline warning. Montana State, their first.
Jeff Choate's got to find that get-back guy on his team to tell everybody to keep getting back.
Isn't there an issue here earlier this season, I think, in a game we did? I believe it was here where Jeff had to get a little busier on keeping everybody where they're supposed to be. Second down and 9. Quick pitch to Troy Anderson. Connor Strom says, not this time.
Just instinctive reaction. Connor Strom sees the movement right out of the gates. The formation kind of caught a few of those Montana players off guard. They weren't sure where to align, but Connor Strom had no issue. Lined up right in the middle where he has all season, and Troy Anderson holds on for dear life.
And third, and just a little less than 9 yards on this play for Murray. Quick throw, that'll be short of the first down. Lance McCutcheon makes the catch. Markel Sanders with the coverage. So fourth down. Jeff Choate with a decision, and it looks like it's been made. They will go for it here.
They're very successful on fourth downs this season.
76% conversion rate, 16 of 21. That is fifth best in FCS football. Large part of that is the mobility of Chris Murray. And here he goes. That's a design draw. Breaks a tackle and gets the first down. They had him. They couldn't wrap him up. And that's what makes him so difficult to defend.
Well, Jesse Sims had him dead to rights in the backfield. Such a great season. There's Jesse Sims right there. He has him. Can't quite get him. Another Montana State tackler, David Shaw, right there. But slippery is Chris Murray, and he's able to get past him.
15 minutes down, at least 45 more to go in Bozeman. The 117th Brawl of the Wild.
It's wide open. It calls for radical new theories and essential truths to make sense of the world and our place in it. It calls for left brain logic and right brain creativity to find our next frontiers. It calls for brain waves and surf waves, passports and puffies, and grizzlies. Lots of grizzlies. The future. It calls for those ready to change the world. The University of Montana. Let's go there.
Montana up 3-0 on Montana State as we're about to start the second quarter. We take a look at the Tire-Rama road to success. Jeff Choate's football team, they like to keep it on the ground. Season average 242.2 yards per game last year. In the brawl, 368. Just 14 so far today. Time of possession in that opening quarter basically split right down the middle. That was not the case in the brawl last season, where Montana State had the ball for 38 minutes in that contest. First down and 10.
track champion as well. You see him leg it out into the secondary, and Justin Strong lowers a shoulder into him, but not before Anderson almost hurdles him and hurdles the Bobcats inside the 10-yard line.
18-yard gain, taking Montana State into the EQC red zone. Murray with the football. Lunging down to the three.
Chris Murray with the quarterback keeper. Brought down by number 43.
Not to think about as a defensive football player, right, with Chris Murray and Anderson and Lassane. And boy, what they can throw at you can be a real test.
Well, just formationally, you know, that sometimes they've got three guys in the backfield. We've already seen them go four wide. Changing personnel right now, bringing in a tight end, another running back. Kevin Cassis joining the huddle. There's Jesse Sims. He's in his defensive troops. We're back against the wall here. As late defender onto the field. Montana State ready to go.
Low snap. Murray's in trouble. He'll lose yardage from the two back to the 4-yard line.
We just waste a play there. I mean, everything in the red zone is so magnified, especially in a game like this. But a low snap, and thankful for Chris Murray having some good hands, because that could have been a disaster for Montana State. But you just can't afford to waste plays in the red zone.
Tucker Shy, one of the tacklers, 3-yard loss.
Get a great look at the Sonny Holland zone, that closed end of here at Bobcat Stadium in the distance.
Third goal. Murray throws it up. Flag on the play. Intended receiver, Mitchell Herbert.
Intended for Mitch Herbert.
And Ryan McKinley with the coverage, but he got there too soon.
Pretty good matchup.
Pass interference. Defense number two. The foul is coming from the end zone. Ball to the 2-yard line. First down.
Boy, it looked like pretty good defense from that vantage point. Of course he wants the flag, and he gets it. You know, we saw earlier in the season that Chris Murray is really having problems just throwing that basic fade route and giving his guy a chance. I thought that was a much better throw, even though a little bit further upfield than he probably wanted it. But first and goal.
Hussein. Stop short.
Well, great defense by the Grizz. Montana State has three lead blockers with motion for Lassane to get behind, and Montana State reacted perfectly, able to shed the blocks and bring him down for a loss.
Connor Strom led the way, got some help from Justin Strong. Personnel changes, Lassane goes off. I believe came. No, it's Troy Anderson coming in.
Look at that formation.
Option, pitch, Anderson, touchdown, Montana State. You know, that's an awesome moment for a kid out of Dillon, Montana. He comes from a Bobcat family. And had no trouble finding the end zone. And get around the edge and begin the celebration as Montana State has its first lead. Gabe Peppinger on for the extra point. Troy Anderson's first touchdown in a brawl.
The future.
Bobcat Stadium, Montana State finds the end zone first. They're up 7-3. Here's a look at that play. Coach Armstrong, the OC, a beautiful formation. Look, all these players, everybody's going to go this side, right? No, it's actually going to be an option to where Favoroso has to take Chris Murray. The guy inside is the only person that can get Troy Anderson, but he's not in position to play it. See, he gets caught inside on the block. formationally, Montana State won that from the very start. Great execution. And when you got that many people to one side of the formation, the defense has to respect it. Just an easy one-man option play for Montana State, and Troy Anderson walks into the end zone.
Fourth rushing a touchdown this season for number 15. He is on the Jerry Rice watch list for FCS Freshman of the Year. As we mentioned earlier, he's been getting a fair amount of time at linebacker as well, playing both ways. For Jerry Louis McGee, still on his feet, approaching midfield, and finally hauled down. But a terrific return by Louis McGee.
Well, special teams always plays a big factor in rivalry games. Jerry Louis McGee can impact the game in a number of ways, but as a returner, both in punts and kickoffs, he can give his team great field position and a nice response by Montana.
Chad Cano with the tackle. Backup linebacker. So from your own 49-yard line, Montana in business. Jensen dumps it off. Jeremy Calhoun with a first down to the Montana State 40. For Jeremy Calhoun, his 11th reception this season.
Great play against his own defense. Everybody vacates, goes deep. A little running back delay route for a first down.
Yard pickup. Of about a yard.
Montana offense, they've got a run or a pass play in any given play that they line up, and Gus Jensen and company tries to get him into the best for the defensive line.
And again, good cutback. Falls forward near the 35-yard line. Zach Wright, defensive tackle, with a stop. Bring up third down. Montana today, 1 of 4 on third down conversions. They need 5 for the first. He decides, I'll go play for Montana. 7-3, the Bobcats leading the Grizz. 9:56 remaining in the first half. Both teams wanting that great divide trophy.
Western Security.
Big Sky Football on Root Sports is brought to you by First Interstate Bank. It's bigger than banking. It's you and I together. By the University of Montana. Let's go there. By Conlin's Furniture, bringing home style, quality, and value for over 80 years. And by the Montana State Fund. Work hard, be safe. You are looking at the Cat Grizz Undie Run, which takes place every time the brawl is here in Bozeman as Montana State students, well, it's not to say it's only students, stripped down and ran through campus yesterday to encourage school spirit, get everyone pumped up for the game. Can't see it. Jason's back by the trees.
Yeah, well, they had the Masters division.
Yeah. Biggest boxers anybody's ever seen. Anyway, everybody having a good time. Yesterday, chilly conditions. Not sure if... All right, we're getting some information that our referee today, Scott Root, is currently getting some form of treatment off the field. Loose football, and it's covered up by Nick Lassane. So the officials on the field have had to make some adjustments down one. It's been interesting. We've had some weird stuff so far, the communication issues with both teams, coaches leaving the booth, going down to the field, back up to the booth. We have an injured referee getting taped up, apparently, and that ball got put on the ground, a 9-yard loss. So third down and 21. Hand off to Lassane. Has a big hole. He'll get the first down. And more. Lassane at the 20. Nick Lassane. Touchdown.
Started out throwing the ball, Tom, but running game is their bread and butter. And you see hat on hat, everybody picked up their assignment. Nobody in the secondary even touches Nick Lassane until Ryan McKinley gets a fingertip on him at the very end. But too little too late is Montana State run game. Again, a huge play in the Brawl of the Wild, and they extend their lead.
Third touchdown, he covers 71 yards. He had a 74-yard run last week, and Nick Lassane is dialed in. Holy smokes, senior out of Dallas, Texas, making his mark with his career coming to an end today. And you know, defensively, Montana, Jason Seymour, that should never, ever happen.
No, they try and guard against big plays, and too many guys not getting off blocks, and Nick Lassane burst through that hole saying, I feel the need for speed. A big play all the way, 71 yards. And right now, Montana on their heels as the Bobcats here with their home crowd. Lots of momentum in their favor.
Up 14-3, so 14 unanswered points now for the Bobcats. And a big smile on the face of Nick Lassane.
Yes. Another senior for this Bobcat football team having big impact in a huge rivalry game, and Montana's going to have to respond.
You get the feeling his teammates were giving the business. Oh, yeah, you were running out of gas around the five. That's why you had to make that left turn. Doesn't matter. He got in. Gabe Peppinger gets ready to kick off. So, look, at 9:07 left in the first half. We have a lot of football to play, but this next drive is going to be at least one where they're not going to want to go three and out or have just a couple of first downs and punt it away. They want to start putting a little pressure on this Montana State defense.
Well, they're going to have to put the ball in the hands of Gress Jensen, and right now, up to this point, a lot of ball control passes. Montana State playing a lot of loose zone. Haven't really got the run game going yet at the Grizz.
Was the approach to keep the ball out of the hands of Jerry Louis McGee. So pop walked up to one of the...
Tucker Shy, I don't think he woke up this morning thinking he was going to get a kickoff return.
Good for him. Bobcat basketball fans, Big Sky Conference packages are now on sale. Join your Cats in the Brick this season at all home conference games for one low price. Visit MSUBobcats.com/tickets to secure your seats. Rush Jensen so far today through the air, 4 of 6 for 50 yards. Jerry Louis McGee, and boy, he didn't have anywhere to go. Bryson McCabe right there on the coverage. What a good pickup on first down for the Grizz. Send it down to Jen Mueller.
Well, Ty Gregorak, the defensive coordinator for the Bobcats, among the most animated coaches on the sideline. It's his 14th brawl of the wild, and the message to his team this week, losing is not an option because it's the losses that will stick with you most. It's not about playing spoilers, it's about beating your rival, and some nice stops for this Bobcats defense so far, Tom.
Jen, thanks so much. Nice timing pattern. The completion to Justin Calhoun. Ty's had a pretty good run in the brawl. 10 wins, 3 losses.
Yeah, and it means a lot to him. Originally from Spokane, he spent the majority of his adult life here in the state of Montana. And he bleeds this rivalry. He used to bleed crimson maroon, but now he bleeds blue.
First down. Jensen has some room to run. Voids the hit. It's a nice game.
You see growth from Gress Jensen right there versus earlier in the season where he might have let that thing go. The play wasn't necessarily there. He's able to get good positive yards on first down and gives his team another chance.
A few weeks back, suffering a concussion. Missed the game against Northern Arizona. Returned last week, so no need to take unnecessary hits. Oh, wide open, and he just underthrew Jerry Louis McGee.
Missed opportunity there, as I think Jerry Louis McGee has a chance to get into the end zone. They bring Mac McNeil in a blitz, and you see Montana State is mixed up as to who needs to take who. And that ball was just thrown into the dirt.
Third down and 4. Montana 1-5 on third down conversions. It off Elijah Lee. Lee with the first down, lunging near the 30-yard line to mark him down at the 31.
Okay, nice ball control passing. They drop deep into their zones. A little running back delay. Take what the defense gives it.
Gain of 11 yards. 23rd catch this season for Elijah Lee. Jensen buys some time. As an open receiver, Jerry Louis McGee tripped up inside the 15-yard line. First down as Montana moves into the EQC red zone.
Not how you necessarily draw it up. You got a little scramble drill. Both receivers right in the same area, but Jerry Louis McGee comes right in front of Keenan Kern to catch that ball and pick up a first down.
13-yard pickup. First and 10 at the 13. Calhoun with room. Jeremy Calhoun, touchdown, Montana. Seventh rushing touchdown this season for Jeremy Calhoun.
Well, great response by the Grizz, both run and pass. You saw the physicality come back. Just a good power run play. Well executed by the Grizz, and Calhoun, a touchdown maker for this Grizz football team, falls over the goal line and gets Montana right back in this thing.
So we talked about the need for a response after that Montana State score. The long touchdown run by Lassane. Montana did exactly that as Jeremy Calhoun, with his 25th career rushing touchdown. 14-10, the Bobcats lead the Grizz in Bozeman.
To Bozeman, everybody. Montana closes the gap with a touchdown drive of their own by that man, Mr. Calhoun. And a great job at the line of scrimmage. You're going to see Robert Luke come around. He's going to pull out in front. The problem is this man up here, Zach Wright, comes up the field, has a chance to make the play, but just runs right by it. Great block by Robert Luke there. Calhoun does the rest, and heck of a response, Tom, by the Montana Grizzlies on the road, and you see the coach's box and their reaction. Now it's the defense's turn to do some damage.
Seven plays, 61 yards, 2 minutes, 14 seconds, capped off by that 13-yard scoring run. Good to see our referee, Scott Root, back on the field after getting some medical attention, requiring a tape job, so hopefully he can be with us for the remainder of this 117th edition of the Brawl of the Wild. Tim Semenza to kick off. And the return. Tyrell Burgess brought down at the 20-yard line as we send it to our Root Sports studio, Angie Bentick.
Guys, I want you to relax, because coming up on the halftime show presented by Avitas Group, we're going to get you all set for the Dam Cup between Portland State and Eastern Washington coming up next. Plus, we're going to bring you all the highlights and stats from this first half of action. It's all ahead on the halftime show presented by Avitas Group. Tom?
Angie, all by yourself in the studio, because Taylor Barton and Brad Adam will be calling that Dam Cup matchup in Cheney right after we're done with our business here in Bozeman. Chris Murray. It's about on the field to see the total yards in this game. Murray through the air, 4 of 6 for 37 yards. He's been contained on the ground and is once again here on first down. You know, until that big running play by Nick Lassane, both of these teams were averaging under 3 yards per carry. He messed up those averages by going 71 yards. But that gives you an idea of how difficult it's been for both of these teams overall so far to run the football consistently. Our first and 10 line is brought to you by the Northern Quest Resort and Casino. Second down and 7 after Murray's 3-yard gain. Five, touchdown, Montana State! touchdown in this game.
Well, I was just going to say, welcome to the Brawl of the Wild, Mr. Anderson. Two touchdowns, having a huge impact early, and you see great blocking downfield by Lance McCutcheon. Right now, in the run game, Montana just not getting off blocks, and credit the Bobcats.
Well, apparently earlier this week when he told Jeff Choate, I want the ball, he meant it. Extra point is good. Montana State extends its lead. 11-21-10.
And this is against a Montana defense that has really been playing good football. They stubbed their toe a few weeks ago against Weber State, but the last two games, they have really played attacking, aggressive football. And right now, this Montana State team offensively is getting that run game going.
Now, here's Lassane. A decoy on the play. Cassis. Little did we know, he's going to run it again. He had another carry. Lassane with a big game. Just doing all kinds of special stuff on the ground.
And Montana playing a lot of man-to-man defense. A lot of these times their backs are turned, and so that secondary taking a little while to react to the football. So you're seeing those big chunk runs for Montana State. And I think what's unique to Tom is that none of the runs are coming via Chris Murray. He's got 8 attempts for negative 7 yards on some of the losses in the pass game and the fumbles. It's coming from the Nick Lassanes and the Troy Andersons and the Kevin Cassis. So lots of different guys touching the football, and really tough to hone in on just one.
It was a 6-play scoring drive, 80 yards, 2 minutes, 58 seconds. Here's Louis McGee inside his 10. Then has a bit of a seam, breaks outside. And boy, he got hit. Here comes a late flag, and this may lead to 15 more yards for Montana.
Yeah. He was held up. Lots of people over on that sideline. Got to get him off.
Got a bit of a mini brawl in the brawl. It took place right in front of the Montana State bench. Louis McGee seems to be okay after taking that shot. Good return out across the 30.
During the return, personal foul, targeting, number 6. That play is under review.
Number 6 is Ben Folsom, so backup safety, a sophomore out of Dillon, Montana.
Take a look at the left-hand side of your screen. Jerry Lou McGee is held up, and that targeting call is going to hold up.
It sure is.
Ben Folsom's day is going to be over. Yeah, just a dangerous, dangerous play. That is exactly why the targeting rule is in effect. You see him lead with the crown of his helmet, which is exactly what they're trying to get out of in this game.
And that's not only for, in this case, Jerry Louis McGee's safety, but for Ben Folsom's safety
100%.
As well.
No doubt about it.
A replay official, Claire Gaussman, having a conversation with Scott Root, our referee.
Good to see that both Folsom and Jerry Louis McGee are okay, but Folsom playing at that lightning speed that these guys do on the field. Sometimes you aren't as aware of what your body's doing as you could be, but this one, Ben Folsom, unfortunately, I think his day will be over.
So this will be a terrific field position for Montana to begin the drive at the 48-yard line of Montana State. Russ Jensen, 8 of 11, throwing the football today from 92 yards. Jeremy Calhoun, 9 carries, 42 yards. Leading offensive players so far. Should get another look at the targeting call. And just waiting to see if it will, in fact, hold.
Lots of extra conversation going on right now with the replay booth. They're trying to determine the yard line that it occurred on to mark the penalty off. We're going to find out here shortly.
After review, the ruling on the field for targeting is confirmed. Number 6 is disqualified for the remainder of the
mentioned, a rivalry game you look forward to it all season long, and it's got to end like that for him. Obviously, not an intentional targeting call, but a correct call nonetheless.
On first down, Jensen was trying to dump it off to Jeremy Calhoun. Room in the central portion of the field.
They're trying to set up a screen. Tyrone Fontenono putting the heat on Chris Jensen. He takes a hit following that play, but no foul on first down, so they do it again on second.
3:41 remaining in the first half. Three-man rush. Here's the dump off Calhoun. He takes a big hit from Conkle. Of about 7 yards.
Well, really nice job by Gress Jensen keeping his eyes downfield that time. There's a lot of noise in the pocket. Calhoun takes a hit, but a big reception. Watch good footwork. This is all that footwork stuff quarterbacks do in the offseason. Getting rid of the football on time. Sets up third and short.
First down. Drop. Keenan Curran just dropping the football. That is his second drop in this first half.
Well, and not just a drop, but a drop after a Montana State scoring drive. You really need to figure out a way to get things back in your favor. That would have kept the drive going in Montana State territory. He cannot get it done. Tough afternoon so far for Mr. Curran in this one.
Eric Williams on the punt. Kevin Cassis to return, standing inside his 10-yard line. With a fair catch at the 6, off to the Root Sports studio in Angie Mintic.
Guys, we have gotten so many Where I Root photos, and the fans just keep them coming. This is a big day for them. It is presented by Payne West Insurance. Katie sends this one in Cincinnati, repping the Bobcats. And a reminder, when you use that hashtag, presented by Payne West Insurance, it does give us permission to use your photo on the air. Tammy from Torrey Pines Pub, a.k.a. Grizzlyville in Las Vegas. And we get this one from Dana, cheering on the Bobcats from Whitefish, Montana. We got one more here. Sarah sends this one in, watching at Daily Sports Grill in Orange County. So, again, Grizzcat fans checking in from all over the country, cheering on to figure out who's going to win this one, guys.
Ange, thanks so much. A really good carry on first down by Nicholas Sain. A really terrific opportunity, Jason, here for Montana State. They're up 11. If they can go put more points on the board just before halftime, they'll get the ball to start the third quarter. They have a real opportunity at hand.
Yeah, they really do. And I look right now at this rushing attack, and a lot of times you're seeing single tacklers get to the ball carrier. You know, defense has got a good rhythm going. When they're getting off blocks, you see two or three guys getting to the ball carrier. Right now, they're not getting off blocks.
That last carry, Nicholas Sain, goes over 100 yards. 6 carries, 104. Here's Anderson, nowhere to go.
There's a much better idea what I'm talking about. If you're able to shed blocks, you're going to be able to gang tackle and hold them down for the loss. You take a look at the rushing game today. We talked about the number of people touching the football. Lassane has had the big 71-yard touchdown run earlier. Troy Anderson's found his way into the end zone a few times. Razzle-dazzle with Kevin Cassis on the run that was supposed to be a pass on a double reverse.
Well, I'll tell you, they're on pace to run just as well as they did last season. They've got 183 yards rushing so far in the brawl last season in Missoula. They had 368 yards in that game. Now, Murray did most of the damage. Today, it's been Lassane and Anderson. Flag coming in. Area where you most likely get a holding call. He's on third down, so that's one that may be declined.
Personal foul. Chop block. Number 76, number 55. Penalties half the distance. Third down.
Dylan Mahoney, 55. Lewis Kidd, 76.
They'll definitely take that penalty, so it avoids a first down by Montana State. You're going to see both these guys engage the same player, and you cannot block high and low on the same guy. It's a safety thing, and it becomes a personal foul. So now, third and a long ways for Montana State. And this is a precarious situation for the Bobcats. You see Jeff Choate looking on, and they're going to call a timeout to talk about it.
First charge timeout of the first half. 30-second timeout.
1:24 remaining in the half. Hey, fans, Uber's the best way to get wherever you're going. Download the app and get your first ride free for up to $10 using the promo code BigSkyFootball. Well, terrific crowd, as you might imagine, here for this rivalry. The two head coaches, Jeff Choate, Montana State on your left, Bob Stitt, Montana on your right. The stakes larger today, quite frankly, for Bob Stitt and his football team. With a win, they are likely to get into the FCS playoffs. Not only likely to get in, but likely to host. Part of the factor into home sites, how many people are you going to put in your facility? And they'll put in 26, 27,000. So they would likely get a first-round home game. If they lose, none of it matters. So really for them, this is a playoff game in addition to this rivalry matchup against Montana State. Third and 10. Hunt team will need to come on. Timeout taken. Presumably by Montana to keep some additional time on the clock for Russ Jensen in the offense. They're going to get good field position.
And Jeff Choate betting on his defense. They've done a nice job here in this first half as opposed to putting that ball in the air with a potential turnover at play. This is as a quarterback, when you get in the huddle and you've got this kind of time left, you've got some timeouts to work with, but it's just kind of like playing sandlot football. You obviously are calling plays, but you're playing much more fluidly. You're getting up to the line of scrimmage. There's not a whole lot of thought. You're just playing on instinct, and it's a lot of times you'll see offenses do pretty well in those type of situations. So Gress Jensen kind of thinking about the next series, hoping that his teammate Jerry Louis McGee at midfield can find a little extra running room.
Time he gets the ball in this situation, a threat to go the distance. Turn to the 45-yard line of Montana State. Good execution by Padmas. Boy, they had him pinned on that sideline, but he's so elusive, still got some good positive yardage.
Yeah, Padmas has been a real weapon for Montana State this year, leading the conference in punting. That kind of rugby-style kick, he can really do a lot of different things from a field position standpoint, but Joey Louis McGee is always going to try and find a way to field that punt. Comes up with a positive return and a chance for Gress Jensen to come in, put some points on the board here in the closing moments of this first half.
12-yard return by Jerry Louis McGee gives Montana the ball, first and 10 at the 45 of the Bobcats. Completed pass, Josh Horner. His 21st reception this season, a senior out of Great Falls, Montana. 9-yard gain, second and one. Jensen, Calhoun, Justin. Down to the 25, they'll give him forward progress to the 24-yard line. 45 seconds remaining. Montana with one timeout. Jensen kills the play. Kills the clock, effectively killing the play. So a second down coming up.
You saw he wanted Calhoun early. He had a good lock on him and just fires it. Sets up the first down after he grounds it. Second and 10 for the Grizz.
32 seconds on the clock. Going for the end zone. And the ball dropped. Good defense. Samuel Akim, the intended receiver. Damian, check it, Tyrell Thomas with the coverage.
Well, this is a play of the high.
advantage. That's exactly what they wanted. Gress Jensen underthrows that ball just a touch. Great play by Thomas to knock that ball loose, but a missed opportunity for the Grizz once again on that man-to-man coverage.
That's a 6 foot 4 inch receiver going against a 5'8" cornerback. Third and 10. Jensen going for Kim. And again, the coverage by Thomas right there. Fourth down coming up.
Close play. I thought he might have gotten there a little early. I thought Bob Stitt was thinking the same thing. You be the judge on this. The cam's at the top of your screen. Come to the middle. Good play again by Thomas.
The field goal team coming on. Brandon Purdy connected from 20 yards for the first score in the game. A long of 47. Career long. That was last week. This will be from 41. Purdy's kick is good. Well, he may be quite a weapon before all is said and done here today. 21-13, Montana State with the lead.
Those are important points for the Grizz.
They really are.
They've come up short now, once in the red zone on their first drive, and then didn't quite get into the red zone here, but those 3 points, even though they didn't get seven, those 3 points are crucial in a tight game. Puts it right down the middle, and Montana State will get the ball back first in the second half. So any points that the Grizz could put on to keep pace with this Bobcat team here on the road are going to be important.
Brandon Purdy, another of the Montana kids playing in this Brawl of the Wild, a sophomore out of Kalispell, Glacier High School. 27 seconds left. Montana State, all three timeouts. If they get a return, the effectiveness of that return may dictate what they decide to do. Logan Jones.
Well, it keeps the run game in play, Tom, when you got those three timeouts. I mean, Montana, typically, Jason Seymour and company probably play a little more conservative defensively on the back end to prevent the big play.
Logan Jones, Tyrell Burgess back deep. This is Burgess. Well, he's got a hole right up the middle. A lot of room. Whoa, brought down at the 38-yard line. Thought he may even be able to get more out of that, but a good return. Guys are mixing it up.
Jerry Louis McGee was in on the tackle there. Good breakdown. And see Burgess, quick player himself, but McGee, he knows those moves. Watch him break down, play off the hips. Just picture perfect by Jerry Louis McGee.
Like he wants some time at safety.
Yeah.
Boy, that middle of the field really opened up quickly for Burgess. He gotten around Jerry Louis McGee, maybe 10 or 15 more yards on that return. That said, first and 10 at the 38.
Come out in an open set, trying to spread out this defense.
Murray, far sideline. As Jabari Johnson. Hey, that drive last week to end the game, to put them in position for that two-point conversion try at Northern Arizona. Very impressive drive. They had a fourth, I think it was fourth and 10. Murray finds Johnson. He makes the catch 2 yards short of the first down. He's got a small defender on him, and he just took him for a 3-yard ride to keep that drive going. So, a guy that can use his size. Well, Chris Murray sacked, and Banks got him. Second sack today for James Banks.
Well, it indicated that Jason Seymour might play a little more conservative to not give up the big play. Correct this, Jason, as being wrong. Jason Stiles was not correct. James Banks, Montana, bringing the heat, and Chris Murray didn't have a shot.
So 11 seconds remaining in the half. Montana State has two timeouts remaining. Here you go, Montana natives. Suited up today for the Brawl of the Wild. Montana State with 46, Montana 25. You have 11 from Billings and 9 from Kalispell. A lot of homegrown talent on display. display here today in Bozeman. We'll see if it's take a knee time or go deep time for Chris Murray. Another option handoff time.
And after that sack, that pretty much puts you in a position where you go in, you played a really good half of offensive football. Montana's going to call the timeout just to see if they can get them to kick it away. And why not when you've got a returner like Jerry Louis McGee, or you put in a punt block that maybe you don't use many times in a season, but this is the time to pull it out.
Late half gamesmanship. Montana State has not won a brawl here in Bozeman since 2005, and they haven't had back-to-back wins in this series since 2002-2003. So, Patmos back in punt formation. Jerry Louis McGee back around his 25-yard line. Ball kicked out of bounds. You might imagine, well played. That's it. First half over, and Montana State heads to the locker room with the 8-point lead over Montana, 21-13, the 117th edition of the Brawl of the Wild, as we send it to our Root Sports studio in Angie Minton.
All right, guys, thanks. Halfway through the Brawl of the Wild, and as we lead you up to the second half kickoff, keep it right here, because we'll preview our second game of the day, the Dam Cup between Portland State and Eastern Washington. Plus, of course, we'll bring you all the highlights and stats from the first half. Just 30 minutes left to play to crown the winner of the 117th Brawl of the Wild. At the half, Montana State leads 21-13. We are back with a halftime show presented by Avitas Group in just a couple of minutes.
They need a comeback victory here in Bozeman, Bobcats Stadium. Those young MSU fans don't want to see that happen today. Let's send it down to the field, Jen Mueller.
Well, in talking to both coaches at halftime, Bob Stitt said he was disappointed with the communication challenges in the first quarter where they weren't allowed to use their headsets. He said it did impact their effectiveness, but thinks that Gresh is doing a nice job throwing the ball. Defensively, look for the Grizz to stay in a base defense, play faster, and do a better job of tackling and defending the run. As for Montana State, Jeff Choate said field position is so big in this game. The Bobcats had that advantage in the first quarter, but then coverage slipped in the second quarter. They'll get a chance to establish good field position coming out here in the third quarter. And guys, one more note, we'll be without the white hat the rest of the game, at least the one who started the game. The umpire will now move to referee. The back judge will move up to umpire, as we did have an injury there on the crew.
Jen, thanks so much. Our referee, Scott Root, a calf injury, so he is unable to go in the second half. So that role will be filled by the umpire, Dave Steierman. So Dave Steierman running the show, and instead of a crew of seven, we have a crew of six moving forward. So we're about to get this second half underway. Tim Semenza kicked off. Burgess. Sideways, trying to find a lane, takes a hit, and will be brought down inside the 20-yard line. Again, a must-win game for Montana to have a hope to get into the FCS playoffs. And in fact, the expectation is if they win, they will be in. Wait for everything to settle, not only in the Big Sky, but across the country in FCS football today. As you look at Chris Murray, has not been the impact player on the ground that he normally is. You see that average, 102.5 per game. second best in the Big Sky, but minus 14 so far this afternoon. First and 10 at the 18-yard line. And the same, trying to get around the edge. Get you up to date on our players to watch today here at Bobcat Stadium.
Well, the Montana State folks have not disappointed. Lassane and Kevin Cassis, two big plays to set up scoring. Josh Buss, just one tackle on the day, and he's going to have to be a lot more active, as are the rest of that Grizzly defensive unit, defending the perimeter against that Montana State run game.
Second down and eight. The same nine carries, 112 yards. Third down, Justin Strong, free safety with a stop.
Good initial contact, too, by Josh Sandry. Low man wins, and Sandry was on his knees trying to get lower than Lassane on that play. First third down of the second half. Neither team particularly effective on third down in the first half. Third down conversions, 2 of 7 for Montana State.
Third and four. Receiver, and Mitchell Herbert has the first down out across the 35-yard line. Well-designed play.
Well, a great route for a big receiver as soon as he gets inside. See how far off Justin Strong is in that short-yarder situation. Safety matched up with Herbert, who moves from the outside into a slot roll. Great play design, great execution, and the first down for the Bobcats. He gets in the end zone one more time, and he has that Bobcat record for touchdown catches.
Murray looking again in the direction of Herbert. Mitchell with two catches today for 21 yards. Has a brother that plays a little bit of quarterback at the University of Oregon, so football, big part of that family. Second down and 10. Down, they will mark him a yard short at the 45.
Yeah, just a bit short, but some nifty footwork, and good decision by Chris Murray to pull it down, not force it. Josh Sandry trying to play that contain role, but Murray's able to get outside of him, pick up a few more yards. So tough to get in the open field, Tom.
Yeah, really good footwork on that sideline. Down conversions. Good look at Chris Murray, just 19 years of age, true sophomore. He'll keep it. He'll get the first down and get into Montana territory. These better runs today.
Yeah, they spread the defense out, taking defenders out of the box, and then run right at it. That time, Connor Strom went from that middle linebacker spot and came down on the edge to blitz. And Chris Murray ran right where Connor Strom left.
6-yard pickup. Now at the Montana 49-yard line. Handoff. Anderson breaks one tackle, breaks a second, tries to break a third. Boy, he's a load to bring down. We've got a late flag being thrown.
The run. Flag on the play.
Well, sure looked like Josh Sandry went flying at the end of that play and may end up on Jabari Johnson. We'll have to see. We'll also have to see if the umpire got the microphone as part of the transfer with Scott Root.
I hope so.
Our referee leaving the game.
Dave Steierman.
Fouls on the play. Holding. Offense number 76. Dead ball, personal foul, offense number 80. Both fouls will be enforced.
Wow. Both fouls to be enforced. And 76, David Reese. Check it. 76 for Montana State, Lewis Kidd. also a number 80, Curtis Amos Jr., backup tight end.
The hole by Lewis Kidd there right in the middle of your screen, all sorts of jersey grab on Jesse Sims. And after the play, Jabari Johnson got in a little altercation and got flagged as well. I should say Lewis Kidd is playing for the injured Caleb Gillis, who's been out the most of the second half of the year. And tough way to end your career, not being able to be on the field. We were told that Caleb Gillis would play probably just one play today so he could at least get on the field. Don't know when that is, if it's already occurred, but Lewis Kidd has had to fill the majority of that role at left guard.
So first and 35. Anderson. Nothing doing. When you back-to-back penalties like that, I mean, it just can kill your drive.
Well, yeah, and a really positive first drive of the second half. They had things going pretty well.
So you can see the distance between the sticks. It's a lot of real estate. Of course, it was third and very long when Nick Lassane broke that 71-yard run for the touchdown. There on the ground for Lassane.
Sure would appear at least that Montana State is conceding this possession with two runs like that, now third and forever. I don't think you're going to put the ball in that man's hands and ask him to throw it. We have seen a lot of open green grass for that man Jeff Choate and his offense in the first half. Some big chunk plays, but you've got to defend against the 39-yard line. It's a long distance to defend, 31 yards, so Montana's got a little room for error here.
Murray tucks it away. Chris Murray with some room. Chris Murray still on his feet, cuts it back. Chris Murray, high tackle. Tucker Shy, I think, eventually got to him at the 45 of Montana, but they brought a lot of folks and they opened some real estate for him.
Well, Montana decides to bring pressure. Like we talked about in the open, you bring that many guys, if you're able to get through that first line of defense, there's a lot of running room for you. Good job by breaking down, making the tackle, Tucker Shy and company. But what that does, Tom, is they look like they're going to go for it on fourth down. Maybe a quick kick here. Be careful. It's a brand new formation.
23-yard gain on the play. Montana State is forced to take a timeout. I'm sure that's not something they want to do in a game that very well could be determined late in the fourth quarter. 9:33 remaining in the third. Bobcats lead the Grizz 21-13.
Whether it's gas mileage, room for the whole family, the power to stand out in a crowd, driving one of the safest cars on the road, or style that makes him look twice. No matter what you're looking for, Toyota's full line of passenger cars have got you covered. Refuse to blend in with the sporty new Corolla, now with these outstanding limited time savings. See your nearest Montana Toyota dealer today. Toyota, let's go places.
Hi, I'm Jamie.
I'm Nate.
I'm Sarah from Northwestern Energy.
Did you know Northwestern Energy adds that skunky, rotten egg smell to natural gas so you can detect a leak? Natural gas is safe,
but leaks can be dangerous. So if you think you smell a gas leak, follow these safety tips.
Do not attempt to locate the leak. Do not use any electrical switches, appliances, or an open flame.
Get out of the house fast. And from a safe distance, call Northwestern Energy.
Together.
Together.
Together, we can deliver a brighter future.
Meet Chris. He's up at 5:30 every morning. Worked at the same place for 30 years. Thursday nights, karate class. This black belt is no karate kid, and that's okay. But hip pain has totally changed his routine. That's why he came to us, because we offer more solutions for hip and knee pain than anyone, which means his treatment is customized, and Chris knows there's nothing routine about that.
Big Sky Football on Root Sports is brought to you by Northwestern Energy, reminding you to be safe and call 811 two business days before you dig. By Western Security Bank, nothing sells like success, yours. And by Fireplace Center, the largest fireplace retailer in Montana. at Miller Dining Hall on the Montana State campus. It reopened about 14 months ago after undergoing a $50 million renovation. It's the largest dining hall on campus, serves at least 7,000 students a day. I bet they, we're not students, but I bet they let us swing by.
I mean, holy smokes. I'd love to sample the cuisine up here.
Now, when you and I are in college, well, first, when I was in college, we took a stagecoach. But dining halls were nothing like they are today. Spirit of the West marching band here at Montana State University.
Take a look at this formation. They can stick right with it. All the line is up to the top of the screen.
Murray will keep it. And Murray, depending upon the spot, may have the first down. First down. How about that? Getting creative.
Well, you save it for games like this.
And we talked about their success they've had all season, Jason, on fourth down.
The creative play, Brian Armstrong and company, they have dialed it up here today. Huge first down for the Cats.
At the 39 of Montana. Wide open, Mitchell Herbert. Brought down at the 10. Darian Nash with a stop. Nice throw by Chris Murray.
I'll give credit, Tom. He has struggled at times this year throwing the football, but he has played to his strengths here today. Single reads, throwing the ball on time, throwing the ball on target to his playmakers. You know, Mitchell Herbert was hoping to get into that end zone to set the all-time touchdown record here at Montana State. Comes up short of that, but a big first down for Montana State inside the 10.
Inside the EQC red zone, first and goal. Murray, straight draw. Brought down, not much there. Matt Shaw with a stop. 96. Second down coming up. Really important defensive situation here for Montana.
He's tackled by David Shaw. Keep in mind, this is the opening drive of the second half. Montana has not had the ball in a long time.
This will be the 14th play of this drive. Play blown dead. Umpire unavailable for the second half due to a calf injury.
Offside. Defense number 49. Half the distance and goal. Still second down.
Jesse Sims shaken up in the first half, but back now. Looks like that long player. Yeah, that was 96. David Shaw. So half the distance. Second down and four. Second and goal. More movement on that Montana defensive front. Play clock at 8. Murray, option, keeps. And Banks with the tackle. Third and goal coming up.
Keep in mind, the rotation for these referees is new, too. They're looking at things that they're not used to looking at. The back judge is now the umpire. So now he's watching the scrum, so to speak, in the mix. There is no back judge now as a result of that. The umpire is now the referee. So lots of different things in play here with that referee rotation, especially down here where lots of running, potential holds, offside, you know, lots of different dynamics as part of that.
Corey Anderson in. Center. Play fake. Nowhere to go. He's in trouble. At the 5. Puts a head down. Denied. He gets around the 2-yard line.
Well, I tell you, Tom, assuming they go for the field goal, and the field goal team is coming out, similar to the stop that Montana State had on that first drive of the game for Montana, holding him to a field goal, this is a huge hold for the Grizzlies.
Good job by Chris Favoroso. He didn't make the tackle, but boy, he blew that play up. So Gabe Heppinger coming on. 6 this season. This will be a 20-yard attempt. And it's good. 24-13.
Montana Grizzlies 13.
Making it a two-score game in favor of Montana State. How about those orange jerseys from back in the day? The Bobcats, the Grizzlies, going head-to-head today for the 117th time.
The few.
It's club with some work to do, down 11, 6:06 remaining here in the third quarter after a very impressive drive. They didn't get the touchdown they wanted, Jason, but it did a lot of damage to the clock.
Yeah, they sure did, almost 9 minutes. You know, that freezes an offense who's looking forward to getting out there and making the adjustments, but a huge stop by that defense. Look at the defensive coordinator, Jason Seymour, on this play. These guys hold strong. Not a lot of emotion, but he knows his defense got the hold they needed. Didn't get off the field as quickly as he would have liked, but got the hold they needed and kept their team in this football game.
16 plays, 80 yards, 8 minutes, 54 seconds. So after first half, it was basically even in terms of time of possession. Now in favor of Montana State, 25 minutes, 41 seconds to 13 minutes, 13 seconds. This is going to be Montana's first possession in the second half. And there's a penalty that'll give Montana some good field position. Mentioned earlier, last season in this game, time of possession.
Kicking team. Ball placed at the 35-yard line. First down.
Last year's brawl dominated in terms of time of possession by Montana State. 38 minutes, 14 seconds, 21 minutes, 46. So, look, it's as of right now, it's playing out quite similarly. Russ Jensen, though, going to get momentum swung back in his team's direction. 11 of 18 through the air, 120 yards, no touchdowns, no interceptions for the redshirt freshman. Swings it out. Jeremy Calhoun could pick up on a first down of 7 yards.
Well, for obvious reasons, they've got to have a good drive here. But after your defense is on the field for 9 minutes, you've got to make sure you stay on the field for a little while here.
Denied the first down. Calhoun, third and short coming up for a 1 yard gain.
State and Eastern Washington have the Dan Cup in their sights.
Good find inside. Touchdown, Portland State.
It's Big Sky Football on Root Sports. Today at 3, 4 Mountain.
Hi, everybody. Angie Mentic here with Ford Sports S. Now, a lot of fans for Montana, a lot of other fans for Montana State. And then you have these houses, the houses divided on the brawl of the wild. The hashtag news is Where I Root, presented by Payne West Insurance. Katie sends this photo in, watching the annual, that Cat Grizz game. And Sarah says, is there in Austin, Texas, a long way away from the Northwest. And go Grizz, beat the Cats for all the wild. 117, getting ready to be decided. We get you back to Tom Glasgow. Again, remember to use that hashtag Where I Root, presented by Payne West Insurance, guys.
Angie, thanks so much. Cassis takes a pitch, fakes the throw, and down he goes. Tucker Shy puts him on the turf here at Bobcat Stadium. Well, they're digging deep in the playbook today.
Yeah, well, a chance to really just put Montana out of this thing. Still a lot of football left, but in terms of just overall morale, you got great field position, take a shot, but credit the Grizz. They stayed home. They're thinking trick play coming out of that timeout that Montana State had to call.
We'll call that a sack. He was going to throw the football, so Tucker is Shy. Notches another one. Not a lot there for Anderson. He'll pick up 4 yards.
If you're this Montana defense, you've been out there almost the entire quarter after the interception by Gress Jensen, the first turnover of the ballgame for either team. After Montana was out there for almost 9 minutes for the opening drive of the second half for Montana State, they have one down to defend and get their offense back on the field.
Third and 10, Montana State today. 4 of 11 on third down conversions. Herbert in motion. Murray looks left, comes back over the middle, and had it wide open. Kevin Cassis just could not get him the football.
You know, that was a little bit surprising, Tom, in that where they are in the football field, as well as their defense has played, I thought maybe you'd see another run play, get up about half the yardage, and then come back on fourth down. Good job staying in the pocket by Chris Murray, but you can just tell his comfort level when he's got all that noise around him, not quite there.
That's one way to get a good view inside of Bobcat Stadium. Look at that roll. And will it be a touchback, or looks like it'll be down around the 1 yard line.
What a hustle play by Logan Jones to get to that football.
I'll tell you, Jared Padmus has been on a roll punting. 6 punts inside the 10-yard line.
Wow, what a play.
The last 3 games coming into this game, and look at that.
Now, he left from the end zone, so I have to think they're going to take a look at this. And
well, I guess it'll stand. That was why I was posing the question. Would it be a touchback, or would it be down at the 2? And it is at the 2. Elijah Lee, the ball carrier. A long way to go. 98 yards needed for Montana to find the end zone.
Second down and 6.
Second down and 6. Jensen has a completion. Out to the 10, Louis McGee with a catch. Our first and 10 line is brought to you by the Northern Quest Resort and Casino. And it's a very important third down and 1 yard to go play. Lee gets the first down with a second effort out to the 14-yard line.
Yeah, if Montana's going to be successful in this second half, they're going to come back and have a chance. Their offensive line is going to have to control the line of scrimmage and get some yards via the run.
Clarification on that punt. The man can be in the end zone as long as the ball is not. So we appreciate that. A replay booth. Keenan Curran. Out to the 28-yard line. First down.
Well, Keenan Curran's the happiest one in the stadium that he caught this one after 2 drops in the first half. It would have kept drives going.
Lee. Across the 30. See, they're trying to find that rhythm now. As far as playing fast, this is how they play. So, not being dictated by the score. Second and seven. Short hops. Calhoun.
We've seen that a couple times from Gus Jensen today, and that's again one of the real routine passes in football. There's just footwork isn't right. He grounds the ball on what would have been a first down. Now it's third and long.
4 of 10 on third down. That's about what they do on third down through the course of the season. They convert 41% of the time. But another one they really need to click on here.
Single safeties. You got a matchup down low with Keenan Kern.
It's coming. And that pressure on Jensen led to a inaccurate throw for Keenan Curran. Yeah, it was Braden Conkle coming in to put the heat on Jensen.
Well, and that's what makes this play. If he has time, he's going to complete this throw. And Braden Conkle makes him rush it. Didn't have a chance. And once again, the Grizz will have to punt it away.
Kevin Cassis. Back at his 30. Eric Williams to punt it away. Passes with the fair catch. At his 32-yard line. 24-13 lead. Montana State hoping to win for the second straight season in the Brawl of the Wild with Jason Stiles. I'm Tom Glasgow. Tell you what, Montana State put some more points on the board right here. It's looking rather dicey for the Grizzlies.
Well, it certainly would make Montana one-dimensional. They're going to have to start airing it out. But Montana State defensively, really, really impressive. They're bringing a lot of pressure off the edge with back Mac Bicknell, controlling the line of scrimmage a little bit. And more than anything, not allowing Montana to get any sort of length of drive. So their offense is maintained on the field.
This Montana defense can come up with a takeaway. That would certainly be huge.
Seven of them last week against Northern Colorado. Credit Montana State today for making good decisions with the football at the quarterback spot and holding on to the ball in the run game.
Ball security has been outstanding for Montana State. Murray's not thrown a pick. He put the ball on the ground once. Lassane recovered it, though. Second down at 9. Passes in motion. Murray keeps it. Down he goes. Getting in there was Josh Buss.
Crowd wants a horse collar tackle, but here's a view from the pit here. Josh Buss coming off the edge. Nice job staying home. You see the athleticism there. But that definitely slipped from the back.
That right hand, which was underneath, may have got some face mask. Buss is having a spectacular season. A Buck Buchanan candidate for FCS Defensive Player of the Year. Junior out of Boise. Murray out to the 35-yard line on 3rd and 14. So the Grizzlies defense doing its job.
Is a 4th down and 7.
Time winding down in the 3rd quarter. A lot of it featured Montana State with the football. They'll go into the 4th with the lead at 24-13. So it's going to take a big effort.
At the end of the third quarter,
by Bob Stitz.
University of Montana Grizzlies 13. Montana
Grizzlies to win a game, win a brawl, and punch their ticket into the FCS playoffs. 24-13 as we head to the 4th.
Clear your path and save some money with Napa and Tire-Rama. This November and December, buy one qualifying Napa wiper blade at Tire-Rama and get the second blade for free. This offer ends December 31st, so hurry in to your neighborhood Tire-Rama. For more details, visit Tire-Rama.com.
Why wait? Beat the crowds and get Black Friday prices now at Conlon's. Everything's on sale store-wide. Save on recliners, living room, dining room, bedroom sets, and much more. Plus, receive a $25 grocery gift card with purchase. Don't wait. Get Black Friday prices now at Conlon's.
Big Sky football fans, you are everywhere. On game day, we get it. You need to connect. Whether you're in Alaska, Montana, Oregon, Idaho, or in Washington, we want to see where you root. Hit us up on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram using the hashtag WhereIRoot, and you could become part of the conversation. For official rules, visit us on Facebook. Use the hashtag WhereIRoot and show us your school spirit. Presented by Payne West Insurance.
Big Sky Football on Root Sports is brought to you by your local Ford store and by CenturyLink, connecting you to the power of the digital world. Bridger Mountain Range here in Bozeman, Montana. As we get ready for the fourth quarter, Montana State leading Montana 24-13. Be sure and stick around after our broadcast. We'll have Portland State and Eastern Washington, a very important game for the Eagles, who are on the brink of not getting in to the FCS playoffs. That's another must-win situation for Aaron Best's Eagles. Padmas on to punt on 4th and 8 from the 35-yard line. Jerry Louis McGee take the rugby-style kick. He has an opportunity. A lot of bounces. He'll just stay away. So another terrific job by Padmas. Let's send it down to the field. Jim Mule, more on the Grizz.
Well, as they get the ball back, Tom, look for them to try to push the tempo here on offense, trying to break some of those big plays, explosive gains down the field. Until the offense can get more points on the board, it's been the defense keeping the Grizz in the game. And here's a small irony. It's got Ty Gregorak's fingerprints all over it. Ty now with the Bobcats, but he's the one who recruited most of those guys on defense to the point that Choke called them the best linebacking core in the country, and they're keeping the Grizz in this game right now.
And Ty said he's really proud of that crew, but he's proud of the guys he's coaching up right now and hopes they can get the job done right here. Jensen getting some heat, throws incomplete. Kenna Simmons, the intended receiver. And one of the reasons why this game has meaning for Montana is when Gresh Jensen was unable to go due to a concussion against Northern Arizona, it was Simmons who rushed for over 100 yards in that tight victory against the Lumberjacks. Second down and 10. In trouble, Jensen. Again, trying to get it to Simmons. I'll tell you what, Keenan Curran, who's a guy you'd love to be able to find target. Tyrell Thomas giving him no room.
Well, they've played a lot of zone coverage, have the Bobcats today, but a few times like that where they want to blitz. They have one-on-one opportunities. Gress Jensen just did not have the time in that particular play.
Montana 4 of 11 on third down conversions. Third and 10. Jensen has a man, has a first down. And Curran on cue makes the catch.
Great curl route. Watch him threaten vertical. Gets that defensive back moving backwards. Gress Jensen finds a hole in the zone and moves the sticks.
Four Bobcats surrendering. Curran picked up 12. Pumping it off, Simmons with the catch to the 35. 3-yard gain. First catch for him today. Second and 6, our first to 10 line is brought to you by the Northern Quest Resort and Casino. Jensen. Why, that ball looked like it was bobbled initially by Keenan Curran, but he held on, and the chains will move again with another first down.
Just a great catch in traffic, too.
Calhoun breaks through the initial line of defense, and he's down at the 40-yard line of Montana State.
Take a look at the catch by Keenan Curran, that play before.
rushing receiver, very tough to cover.
Third and two. Blitz coming. Jensen has his man. First down at the 25. Keenan Curran once again.
First time all game we've been able to see Chris Jensen getting a rhythm, throwing multiple passes, and right now nobody seems to be able to guard Keenan Curran.
At the 25. 7 yard pickup on the last play. Jensen looking for Calhoun in the end zone. Ran out of room and well covered. Bryson McCabe. Bryce Alley there, a pair of seniors, two of the 14 playing their final game.
With the pace that Montana plays, that lots of guys in that secondary for Montana State huffing and puffing. Montana can rotate their receivers, but Montana State can't do so with their secondary.
11th play of the drive. Flag.
And that's going to be a false start.
False start. Offense number 76. 5 yard penalty. So second down.
Left tackle David Reese. Well, oftentimes it's not how many penalties, it's when you get the penalties. We'll see if they can overcome that 5 yarder, making it second and 15. Jensen. Boy, nice job feeling the pressure. Gets those 5 yards back as he's down at the 20. He does a nice job of that, Jason, just having a sense of the pocket collapsing and where he can go to buy himself some more time. Third and nine. They are in pretty field goal range. They'd like to get a touchdown out of this drive. Jensen. Corner short of the first down. Brandon Conkle with the tackle. Field goal team is coming on. So if they can put this through, it'll make it a one possession game, a touchdown and 2-point conversion. Player down on the field is Brayden Conkle.
Already has that lower right leg taped up. Wonder if that might be an aggravation of whatever type of muscle strain he's got. He's able to run off under his own power, which is a good sign.
Brandon Purdy has knocked a couple of home today from 20 and 41 yards. This will be a 35-yard attempt. Kenneth Simmons is the holder. That's hooking at the end. But he got it through.
Yeah, the entire Montana side holding their arms up. And, yeah, the entire Montana State side saying it no good. But Purdy's able to get it snuck through. And now Montana's defense turn. They need to force a turnover, get a stop. They want to win the 117th Brawl of the Wild.
What would you do? How would you grow? What would you try if you just had the time? With Avitas Group, the time is now. To focus on creating the business you always knew you could have and finding out just where you could take it, so you can rediscover the reason you went into business in the first place. Isn't it about time? Avitas Group. Simplify, strengthen, and grow your business.
There's a lot of factors, I think, that go into it. I think you can just, purely the talent level of some of the upper-level programs. You look at Eastern Washington, for example. They have two guys drafted, which I think Southern Utah did 2 years ago. There's a reason why. If you've got two NFL players on your roster in the Big Sky, you're probably one of the best programs in the Big Sky.
You know, I think that something about the Big Sky is that nothing is given. Every team, they can beat you any given week. It doesn't matter where you're from. As long as you go out and bring it, you can win and be successful.
I think when you look at all the teams that have been successful, they've had great team chemistry to begin with. Guys that are stuck to the, you know, they buy into the vision. I think to have playmakers. You got to have guys that are able to take advantage of matchups.
Going deep. Touchdown, Northern Arizona.
It all starts with loving to play football and wanting to play good football. And that's what we talk about with our kids all the time is just take pride in doing your job. Don't really want to talk about championships. Just play great football.
Hi, everybody. Angie Mantic here at the Forward Sports Desk, reminding you to keep the photos coming, and I'll keep putting them on the air. You have to use the hashtag Where I Root, presented by Payne West Insurance. Deanna checks in with this one. House divided there. It's a common story we're hearing today. Pete checks in from San Diego, 19th year at McGregor's. Go Cats. And go Grizz here. And Cats? Conflicted there. Becky sends that photo in. And I think we have one more. Yep, Brooke checks in. Cat and Grizz fans cheering from Kalispell. So you see, they can all get along no matter what the outcome of this game is, and that's encouraging. Tom, as we get it back to you.
All right, Angie, thanks a lot. This one's still very much up for grabs. 10:44 remaining in the fourth quarter. Montana State with a 24-16 lead after Purdy's third field goal in this game. A lot on the return for Burgess, but he does get out close to the 25-yard line. Extra curricular activity right there.
Wouldn't expect anything less from a rival again, would you?
Not at all. Not at all. It's been rather calm. You know, we had that one targeting hit in the first half in front of the Montana State bench. Things got a little chippy and a little pushy, but beyond that, these two teams just trying to win a football game.
No points for second place in this one, boys. That's what they're saying in the state of Montana.
Chris Murray, solid day. Not a great day, solid day. 7 of 11 through the air. They have, they being the Montana defense, have done a good job containing him on the ground as he picks up 5 yards right there.
Chris Murray with the quarterback keeper.
No back-breaking plays on the ground from Murray. We've got a Montana player injured.
Backside guard, get out. Pull, get out in front.
Not sure if that might be right there, 36, Banks spinning off. Yeah, you see him hold his right shoulder, James Banks. Hey, James is a really interesting story. We'll tell you more about him when we come back. 10:23 left to play here in Bozeman. Banks able to get off the field under his own power, shoulder, upper arm issue. Having a terrific game, 11 tackles, 2 sacks, 3 tackles for a loss. Senior, this is a kid who was at Alabama Birmingham. You remember when they pulled the plug on that program, he needed a place to play some football, and Connor Strom was the guy. These are a couple of Oregon kids, and Strom basically said, why don't you head this direction?
Yeah, we got a spot for you.
We got a place you can play some football, and as we mentioned earlier, Ty Gregorak then had Montana, got involved in the recruitment, and just like that, James Banks found his way from Alabama to Missoula. Second down and 4. Chris Murray and crew happy to work some time off the clock. Murray on the keeper. Tucker Shy gets to him and he's driven back. Josh Buss also in on the stop, so third down coming up.
Well, smartly, you see Chris Murray's got both hands wrapping that football up. Lots of time left in this game, but certainly Montana needs to try and make their own breaks here at this point to get the football back. Leader of that defense, redshirt senior Connor Strom.
Third down conversions today for Montana State, 4 of 13. Need to get 4 yards here to move the ball, move the chains. Should do it. Cassis with the catch just beyond the 35-yard line. Well done by Murray.
A healthy spot for Montana State. Good strike by Chris Murray to Kevin Cassis. 3 in routes. Tough to defend. You have to really move through the offense. to the football. See, he catches that just shy of the 35-yard line. Ball's ended up marked at the 36. I think they still would have had the first down.
Good read by Chris Murray saying, this is our house.
Well, these teams playing for the Great Divide Trophy, modeled after Bear Mountain in Homestake Pass overlooking Butte near the Continental Divide. Now, this trophy was first awarded in 2001. The last time it's going to be awarded will be at the end of this century. And at that point, the school with the most wins will get to keep the trophy forever. I can hardly wait to find out, although I don't think I'll be, sadly. There you go. There you go. Well, future generations are going to enjoy that moment.
Well, the new Champion Center, Montana, has got a space in that wall right now that's vacant, and it's made for that Continental Divide Trophy. We've got a long way to go if they're going to bring it home this year. And the Bobcats now up 31-16, just a precious 6 minutes and 20 seconds left.
The way it's going right now, that old car could just hang a U-turn and just go right back to where they got it from. But certainly time and with an offense with the explosive capabilities of Montana, but they got to get something going on this possession quickly. And Jerry Louis McGee says, maybe I can just handle it myself. Nice return out across the 30-yard line. He's 19 years of age, true sophomore. Chris Murray, quarterbacks in the Big Sky, rushing for over 1,000 yards in a season.
A really good comparison to Chris Brown from Cal Poly. Of course, they run the triple option. Really similar players, and passing is not their forte. They can get it done when needed, but boy, they can sure run the ball and change the game and chew time off the clock.
Chris Jensen, got to get something going. Louis McGee with a catch in Montana State territory and inside the 40-yard line down to the 38. See, just like that, an explosive play, and the Grizzlies in business.
Oh, what a throw just over the outstretched arms of a 5'7" Jalen Cole. Is now Braden Conkle is back down on the ground. Well, that's McCabe.
Bryson McCabe, 29-yard gain on this pass, Jensen to Louis McGee.
So Jalen Cole, who again was out the entire first half due to a targeting penalty from last week's game in the second half, could not get his finger on that one. Jerry Louis McGee waiting along the sideline. Bobcat fans will be happy to know that Bryson McCabe is running off under his own power. Josh Hill and McCabe are over to make that tackle. We'll see if McCabe's able to come back in.
McCabe, another of the 14 seniors playing their final game today. Inside of 6 minutes. Quickly to McKenna Simmons. Tried to power for a few extra yards.
Eight people in coverage for the Bobcats. Not a whole lot of space out there, but take what the defense gives you. In Montana State territory.
This may factor in on an additional possession if Montana gets one. Right now they have all three of their timeouts. Going deep, caught, touchdown! Montana to Keaton Curran. What a throw by that man, Chris Jensen.
Well, at some point you got to figure out. Montana fans are home going, he's getting impatient. Take the shot. Well, they take the shot. They get the coverage they wanted. You see Gress Jensen's eyes holding the safety. And Curran does his job, beating the defender one-on-one, beats Tyrell Taylor. Tyrell Thomas beats Thomas. And a great catch, great throw, and Montana's not dead yet.
32-yard touchdown pass. Purdy on for the extra point. It's good. And back to a single possession game. Montana touchdown and 2-point conversion away from tying it. And after some drops in the first half, Keenan Curran back with a vengeance.
Well, definitely a favorite target of Gress Jensen. He's got great chemistry with him. He's gone to him early and often in the second half. And Keenan Curran has made up for a sloppy first half with some huge catches in this one. Catches that kept drives going. Catches like this that keep him right in the ballgame.
Keenan Curran with his 7th touchdown reception this season for Gress Jensen. His 20th touchdown pass.
Well, you see how close with that Super Bowl came. Tyrell Thomas' hand was right there. Just unable to locate the ball to knock it out of the
22-23-yard line. That was number 57 in on the stop. Shane Cochran. Chris Murray going to work last time out. Always have to know where he is, and as good as Josh Buss is, doesn't have the speed to deal with Murray. This is the one he nearly broke for the touchdown, covering 36 yards. But in the end, he found the end zone. We'll see what he can do now. Tana hoping to get a three and out, quick bubble screen. Mitchell Herbert. Right down and gain 4 yards.
See at the bottom of your screen, those three all-important timeouts are still left for Montana. See those rushing yards, using the negatives that first half. Second half, big change. So many different guys touching the football have had impact for Montana State. You got Nicholas Ames, 123 yards. Chris Murray, 94. Troy Anderson, 64.
Second down and 6. Murray keeps. Cochran right there. He's tackled for a loss of a yard.
Cochran filling in for the injured James Banks, who is a senior. He's hoping his team can continue the comeback so that his season could potentially continue. You don't want to ever have to finish your career on the sidelines. Look at Cochran. He's doing his best to take care of that. See James Banks injured that right shoulder earlier in this fourth quarter.
Jason, I wonder here if Montana comes up with a stop, do you take a timeout to protect some time ahead of the punt? But they've got to take care of the first part of that scenario. Murray has the completion, but short of the first down. And Bob Stitt will take the timeout immediately with 3:50 left to play here in the fourth quarter.
Chris Murray, ideally, you want to keep your receiver up if you can. He throws this down and in front, which is a good location for a slant. But on third down, you want to give your kids the opportunity to finish up field. See Sandry right there on top of it, but well short of the first down is Kevin Cassis. Just 98 yards throwing the football for Chris Murray today. But Tom, I will say that it's not always the number of yards, but how effective you are through the air. And I feel like Chris Murray has been really good with his decisions today, and the passes that he has completed have been key to either extending drives or moving the football, getting them into down and distance situations that allows them to run the ball effectively.
Well, in the end, we'll find out how critical that 1 yard will be in the outcome of this football game. As that conversion on third down coming up just short. Montana State has not won in this rivalry at home here in Bozeman since 2005. Badness. Boy, McGee will just have to back off. That ball continues to take a really nice roll. I'm not sure why everybody doesn't go the rugby style end over end now in college football. We're seeing more of it, but you can see the effectiveness of it when it's done well. And Jared Padmus has done it well for a good portion of the season. Well, Ty Gregorak, this is his 14th brawl. Most of them as a Montana Grizzly. But there's no doubt what he wants to see in this sequence, and that's his Bobcats defense rise to the occasion against a Montana offense that just went for a touchdown in less than a minute. And here we go in Bozeman. Jensen with time, has a man, it's Louis McGee. That's a rare instance where the first guy to get to Jerry Louis McGee actually makes the tackle. He's usually beating that first guy, but first down yardage for the Grizzlies.
Jalen Cole's who they wanted to match up on Jerry Louis McGee. Two guys that are lightning quick.
12-yard gain on that play. Jensen, a lot of time. He can run or throw. Look at that. The ball came coming out of his hand as he threw the football. Is it ruled a fumble or an incomplete pass? Waiting for a signal. This is certainly going to replay. We do know that regardless.
The ruling on the field is we got a fumble recovered by Montana State.
Larry Gausman, our replay official, with a huge decision. Here we go.
I think that's coming back. That looks like complete to me from that view. Supermo camera.
Yeah, his hand's clearly going forward, so.
Yeah, the ball was, while leaving his hand, was still in his hand as his arm came forward. And the right call by the officials, too, because they can always go back and reverse that, but difficult to do it the other way.
Well, Claire Gausman.
That's right.
On the hot seat. We just will sit back and see how this plays out. But the magnitude of this call is something that cannot be understated.
You know, I think what Chris Jensen was going to be doing, too, is trying to go down the sideline. And Keenan Curran had turned up field.
Chris Jensen, as you see on the screen, he was getting his right arm and wrist checked out to see if he can even throw the football.
No, not a chance.
So he's done. So McKenna Simmons, we expect to come on. Caleb Hill would be another option. There's Simmons.
It makes you wonder if Chris Jensen hurt that wrist the play before because of the way that ball came out of his hand on that play they're reviewing. Then just watching him trying to throw that ball on the sideline. I mean, there wasn't a chance he could get rid of that ball.
Or did he injure it? There's Hill warming up. We talked to Bob Stitt about it. It's kind of game situation and what they would need. Hill has been a mixed bag. He kind of was a little moping around due to some issues he's had in terms of results and playing time. And Bob Stitt telling us, you know, Caleb, you got a call from his dad. And, you know, those phone calls happen quite often. You know, a mom or a dad will step in and say, hey, you need to reboot, refocus. And so Bob was really happy with how that call went.
After review, the quarterback did not have control of the ball when his arm is coming forward. Therefore, we have a fumble on the field, recovered by Montana State. First down.
Shows you what I know.
There you go.
May have misinterpreted the rule, but in my mind, if the ball's in his hand and his arm is going forward, and the reason that the ball goes forward is because of his arm, to me that's an incomplete pass. But these guys know the rules inside and out, and an unfortunate turn of events for that man, Gresh Jensen, and the Montana Grizzlies had a huge turnover the second of the game for Montana.
So two timeouts remaining for the Grizz. This has got to be a three and out situation to get the ball back, or maybe this is going to really be a four-down situation for Jeff Coates' team. We'll see, but a first down will all but end this game. Here's the same. No, Murray on the keeper. Good cut back and a good pickup on first down. Boy, that is just, from a Montana perspective, that is a heartbreaking, bizarre play to lose the football on.
Just curious when Gresh Jensen injured that wrist to the point that it affected the way he could throw like that. And on this end, Chris Murray on that run, so difficult to defend. I mean, his stop and start is 0-60, if you will, in terms of his speed, is something else.
Second down and four. Taken by Montana.
Stopped by Justin Strong.
All right, we're going to go back. We're going to take a look at the play prior to the Jensen fumble. We try to figure out where he may have injured that hand.
Didn't look
looked like it got hit there. He was definitely shaking it at that point. Just makes you wonder if he...
maybe even something prior to that.
Yeah, because there was no contact with his throwing hand in that particular play.
Still receiving treatment. You see his numbers today? 25 to 38, 272 yards, touchdown, interception, connecting with eight different receivers.
Yeah, spread it around well. Obviously, the fumble we just saw in that interception, two key plays. But
what might the reaction be if Bobstead's team cannot pull it out? There'll certainly be a lot of unhappy Montana fans for a second straight year unable to get into the FCS playoffs. Murray to the air, and Herbert dropping what would have been a first down. Now, what will they do on fourth down?
Yeah, interesting, based upon field position, as well as Jared Padmus has punted that football, as well as your defense has played, you think about kicking it down there and making them go the long field with just 2 minutes and 18 seconds left where they put it away here.
With a backup quarterback.
That's a great point.
Maybe they'll just use this to try to draw Montana offside.
It's a
Murray
quick kick.
It's a quick kick. Yep, you see it by the yardage he backed up. Takes a little bit of a Montana bounce. 2:08 left to play. Montana with one timeout remaining. Ty Gregorak's defense hoping to rise to the occasion as Caleb Hill will get the nod at quarterback. Threw a pick six last week, but that one really was more of an issue with the receiver and not Hill, as Chris Jensen's trying to get himself available to get back into this game.
It's got to be a ligament or a muscle strain or something, because now he's got some zip back on that ball.
Hill in some trouble, and down he'll go.
He's got to get rid of that football.
I was going to say, you just throw it on the ground, put it by a receiver, and save the time on the clock. You can't take a sack situation. Here comes Jensen. Rolling, 1:45, second down and 11. Overthrows Curran. We had to rush back out onto the field. Now he gets settled in to third down. Of 14 on third downs today for Montana. Jensen in trouble. Dumps it off to Jerry Louis McGee with some room. And Louis McGee with a first down, still on his feet.
Oh, what a play.
Wow.
Jerry Louis McGee.
He's about to go down. Defenders converging on him, and able to just flip it to Jerry Louis McGee.
I tell you, anytime he gets the ball, there's some open field to work with. Has the potential to go the distance. Dump off here to Jeremy Calhoun. First down and out of bounds. And things are starting to get awfully interesting at Bobcat Stadium.
I just don't know what Gresh's limitations are with that arm. It's almost like the flexor muscle, something's cramping, and so that extension on those big throws, not sure he has it, but he's certainly managing well as they get down towards midfield.
Again, they still have one timeout. 17-yard pickup on that last play. Dumps it off in a big hit as McKenna Simmons made the catch.
McKenna Simmons, Joshua with the stop. It's second down, time to touch.
Inside a minute remaining. Second down and three. Jerry Louis McGee, close to a first down.
He's got it marked. He's definitely got it. So he'll stop the clock and move the chains. Montana, they're used to this tempo.
Yeah. Josh Hill with the coverage.
A chance now with the incompletion for Montana State to rotate their defensive line so they get a fresh set of pass rushers.
Elijah Lee coming on as Jeremy Calhoun heads to the Montana sideline. Second and 10. Jensen buying himself some more time. I think he had to run that in the end. He had linemen downfield. A good decision. Stops the clock. 29 seconds left.
Yeah, really good awareness by Jensen and his two. Time on the clock, where he was on the field, getting out of bounds. Montana State defensively playing a Tampa 2. They're dropping that middle linebacker deep into coverage along with the other safeties. Now they drop down to a single high look.
Third and 3. Blitz coming. Conkle coming through, nearly intercepted. Chase Benson, defensive tackle, nearly ended the game.
Well, really, it was Conkle that almost ended the game as he puts a helmet right in the back of Chris Jensen, just bouncing that ball directly into the arms of the defensive end, who he's not used to having that ball in his direction.
Fourth and 3, Montana State can win the game, holding here. Blitz. Quick pass. Justin Calhoun with a first down inside the 30. Touch throw and catch. Gritz. Jensen to Calhoun. They'll kill the clock.
Boy, what a clutch play on fourth down. And a difficult 1-2 matched up against senior Bryce Alley. Calhoun able to corral it, get straight to the ground. And boy, a gutty performance by Chris Jensen. Whatever he's got going on with his arm, doesn't have the zip that we've seen him. But he had the accuracy on that play. And now everybody on their feet here at Bobcat Stadium for the last 18 seconds of this one.
Nearly intercepted by Conkle. Dropped at the 20-yard line.
Well, Ty Gregorak is beside himself right now on that sideline. Multiple times this season, he said, I'm sick and tired of seeing our guys be in position to make a play and not make it. That's twice now on this drive that Montana State could have ended this football game.
Third and 10. 14 seconds left.
Timeout for Montana State.
Their final timeout, Montana with one remaining, one that they may save if you get a completion.
Timeout, Montana State. It's a 30-second timeout.
And you can't get out of bounds.
Yeah, I think with that extra timeout, it gives you a chance to work the middle of the field, which I think you need to do.
Interesting to find out what limitations Jensen may be dealing with in terms of where he can throw the football, if any, on this drive.
He's got a heating pad on that right arm as they talk to him.
Mac Bignell ending what has been a terrific career for him here at Montana State. Leading tackler on the squad. 12 tackles for loss coming into this game.
Who's that linebacker playing in the deep middle? Josh Hill.
Jensen has time. And overthrows Jeremy Calhoun with 9 seconds left, and it brings up fourth down. You scramble around too much, get a completion, but don't get out of bounds or into the end zone. The game may end that way.
Boy, what an atmosphere here at Bobcat Stadium. Everybody's bouncing up and down in the stands. Fourth and 10. Continental Divide Trophy on the line and the season for the Grizzlies.
Jensen has a man. Incomplete. Tyrell Thomas saves the day for Montana State. Ty Gregorek celebrates. Jeff Choate will go to 2-0 in this game. And Montana players trying to plead their case for a pass interference call they will not get. And they will not get a bid to the FCS playoffs.
Well, now there are people trying to bring the Continental Divide Trophy onto the field. There's a cart on the field. There's 4 seconds left.
Looks like it's members of the ROTC hustling it back off the field.
Well, Choate said, beat the sky and win the state. They definitely won the state today.
Montana State getting its first home win in this rivalry since 2005. And back-to-back wins for the first time in the brawl since 2002-2003. And for the Montana Grizzlies, a second consecutive season that they will be denied a trip to the FCS playoffs. Seniors for Montana playing their final game today. 14 seniors for Montana State, the same. And this is one they'll all talk about for a long time, but it's the 14 that'll have the better story.
And Chris Murray, what a second half he played. Great decisions with the football all day long as the Montana State crowd rushes the field. The Continental Divide Trophy is at midfield.
Send it down to Jen Mueller. She is with Chris Murray amidst the madness.
Yeah, there is quite a bit of mayhem down here. Chris, what can you say about the effort of your defense and that final defensive stand?
Yeah, you know, last year it was our job to, you know, kind of finish it. And defense did a great job of stepping up second half. And, you know, they finished it for us. You know, they stepped up big time.
You guys were coming off a very complete effort on offense last week. What was the point of emphasis this week?
Just to start off fast and finish strong. That's it, really.
What about Nick Lassay making the most of his senior campaign tonight?
Man, I'm just as a person, I'm really proud of that man for what he has overcome this season. Really.
Lastly, you have started your career here in Bozeman with back-to-back brawl wins. What does this mean for you personally?
I'm 2-0 against the Grizz, and I'm planning on being 4-0.
Well, he's gotten off to a good start there as Bobcats win this brawl back-to-back for the first time since 2002-2003, Tom.
Jen, thanks so much. The Great Divide Trophy with a helmet on top, making its way right back where it came from, and security taking the goalposts down so the student body doesn't have an opportunity to do that. And they're just going to parade around the field and let Montana State fans enjoy this moment. What a terrific game to watch here today in Bozeman with the loss. Montana's season will end 7-4 overall, 5-3 in conference play. Montana State 5-6 overall, 5-3 as well in conference play. And with a win over Montana. As you look at the former Grizzly, Ty Gregorek, defensive coordinator in Missoula before coming here to take the same position under Jeff Choate.
Well, it's just a fantastic rivalry football game. First time they've won here in Bozeman, have the Cats. And we talked about Jeff Choate having that season-defining moment. They're not going on to the playoffs, but this is a team.